Hi guys, this is John with Neighbor with Cars, and here's Hugh.
Hey, what's up?
On the last video, we toured his garage, and on this episode, we're gonna tour my garage. A pretty much similar layout. We built our homes at the same time. The layout is pretty much similar, it's just mine's a lot more messy compared to his, and I have one less lift and less cars. Here you can see the barber chair that actually our cameraman today is Johnny. He's our neighbor concierge Porsche mechanic because he used to work at Porsche River Oaks, but he moonlights as a barber as well. So this is the barber chair that he has that he leaves in my garage, but he cuts my hair. He cuts all our neighbor's hair. So this is Tam. He can kind of elaborate on how he tapped into the Porsche brand itself and how I think I pretty much got him into it. He can talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, years ago, John got a 2014 GT3.
Yeah.
He's always been very generous with sharing his experience with cars. Yep. And he let me drive that thing, and man, I've wanted one ever since. He got a Voodoo 3RS a couple years after that.
Yeah, 2016 991.1 Voodoo Blue GT3 RS, and and he drove that as well.
Yeah, that one still stays in the group of friends. Yep. You might see that in future videos. John lent me this car, and I've been doing stuff to it, and just kind of made the experience one of my own. I did the Advan GT wheels to it, added a Varus wing. This was Hugh's original car. He added the cage to it, and that stayed in there. What else?
Seat inserts.
Got some seat inserts from P1, did a short shifter on it.
Yeah.
And we have a JCR, a full race header and exhaust on it. It's catless, kind of stinks.
Went to the track with us whenever me and Hugh took our 4S's out to Coda. His cars was blowing our ears out all throughout the whole track. The funny thing is, my first GT3 had Advan GTs as well, and I think it was like Mag Blue or something like that, whatever it's called. And now that he has Advan GTs on this, it looks good too as well. And he lowered it. It's a lot lower than normal GT3s.
With the help of our friend Neel.
Yeah, Neel. Yeah, that's our other friend that's here today. And currently he owns a 2024 GTS, 911 GTS Cabriolet in black. But that wasn't his first one. He actually came into the brand last year with us. He bought a Taycan 4S Cross Turismo.
Oh my gosh.
That all stemmed from me inviting him and his brother, Ravi, to a track event that Porsche North Houston was hosting at MSR Houston. And we got to test drive the 911s, Cayennes, Macans, and Taycans. He can kind of speak to that. And Hugh's had some experience with Taycans as well. He can tell his experience about that.
Yeah, the Taycan was the first one, but originally it was John's gray GT3 that everyone's driven. That was the first car that everyone drove and got us all into the Porsche brand. But once I got at the MSR track day with the Taycan and saw the capabilities of it, it was almost capable as a GT3. I had to get it, especially with the Cross Turismo. The Cross Turismo is fun. If you could ever experience one, I would definitely go experience that car. But the traded in for the 24 Carrera GTS, a fun car, Cabriolet. But that one's gonna get traded in soon. Hopefully I can step up to GT cars like these guys.
Yeah, Neel's trying to follow, I guess you could say, follow our steps of how we got into the Porsche brand and trying to, you know, elevate our status, and that way we can get more allocations and trade back in and things like that. He actually owns the shop as well, and he's a good guy that wrenches on cars. He's here today at my house because he needed to borrow the lift and swap out his exhaust. Hugh actually had a Sharkworks exhaust on his 911 GTS 992 as well. Took it off, traded that in, and just sitting around, and Neel borrowed it for a little bit while he was driving his GTS around. He's putting it back to stock and trading it in and hopes for an allocation or moving up to a 992 GT3 maybe, and manual as well.
Yeah, manual.
Yeah, we're all purists here. We all prefer the manual if possible, but as you know, on all RS cars are all PDK, which is great as well. For some reason, he always ends up with black cars. I don't know why, but yeah, black cars like my 4S are the hardest to keep clean. But yeah, his Taycan was black as well. And
black on black.
Yeah, black on black. And that was the first car he kind of learned how to ceramic coat, kind of taught him the ropes on how to ceramic coat. That's the event where we all shipped our cars to Atlanta, Georgia for my bachelor party. That was a fun trip. We all shipped our cars over there to Helen, Georgia at Obsessed Garage, Destination OG. House is amazing. Got to use all his products, try different things, and we drove our cars back. Over there, we got to experience all our cars on the mountains. I test drove the Taycan as well, his Taycan through the mountains, and that thing was amazing. I'm sold on the Taycan, minus if it can work out a few kinks. Hugh can kind of talk about what his experience on the Taycan was at the track at MSR. Yeah.
Yeah, we went out for a test drive on the track, and I think maybe halfway through the track, it overheated. It went into lip mode. And I was like freaking out. I was like, what did I do? What happened? Car just basically went to like 5 miles an hour.
It overheated.
Yeah, it overheated. It went to 5 miles per hour, and then we just pulled out the side of the road and towed us out.
And we see Hugh and Mimi in the Taycan like broken down on the side. We're like, he's not buying a Taycan anytime soon. I won't get into politics or anything, but I'm not into EV. My wife is. She has a Tesla. But if I were to buy an EV, it would be a Porsche EV, which is a Taycan.
It's a fun car.
But the Taycan that went down, they got it back up and running within an hour.
Yeah.
It just had to sit and just cool down.
Because it kept hot lapping pretty much, just from what I heard.
The mechanics, they kind of found out like, all right, maybe the batteries were overheating, whatever. Yes. Once that car was up and running, I pushed it around the track and I felt 100% safe in that car. That car handled just like a 911.
Yeah.
It was crazy knowing that it's a heavy car, battery underneath you. And we were doing hot laps around MSR. I didn't feel like this car was gonna fly off.
Yeah, I think the Porsche has like some torque vectoring, like really special torque vectoring on that car. Like through the mountains, I was pushing it pretty hard too, and I didn't lose grip. The car felt stable. Like it felt like a car on rails, which is unusual for an EV. I think that Porsche heritage of performance has carried into their EVs as well. We're excited to see how the new models of EV, the
Turbo S is coming up. The Turbo GT.
Yeah,
Turbo GTs. Yeah.
Icon Turbo GT. Yeah.
Taycan, the 718 EV, Macan EV. It'll be exciting for things to come this year in 2024. We plan on traveling a lot and bringing our cars, whatever cars we got, and things like that. And hopefully 2024 is a good year for awesome allocation. Keep an eye out for those. So moving on, you can see here on the lifts, we have the 2024 Turbo S that we spec'd in Arctic Gray and Neodyme. Neodyme wheels, pretty middle of the run spec, nothing too crazy. MSRP was 249 or 250, just middle of the run. And then this one's a fast car, but we're used to GT cars. We like that fun drive, go-kart feel, and just driving on rails. This one is a little just a touring, I guess you can say, or a street car daily, but it's just fast and fun. And then below the rack, you can see my 2024 GT4 RS that I acquired a few months ago. I had to pry it from the arms of the manager at North to sell it to me because I wanted something to replace my twin turbo R8. And yeah, he finally let it go. So I bought this one used with like 400 miles or 500 miles, pretty low. And that same week, took it to Coda, tracked it with the rest of our friends as well, and including Hugh. And this car is extremely fun. Compared to the 991.1 GT3 RS, which I had at Coda as well, this one is just a different feel, different sensation, emotions that are pulled out when you're driving it and behind the wheel. And right now for me, this is the top Porsche car for me right now, until I drive a GT3 RS. And then too, you can see my dog, Shiro. She's just hanging out.
Can you see the Shiro?
Yeah, Shiro's over here. You can.
Shiro's just chilling.
Yeah, chilling. She actually came with me too. My wife and Shiro came with me to Austin in the 4RS.
I think Shiro approves.
Yeah, she likes it a lot. She likes the Porsches. She has fun. But yeah, and then our garage, you'll see a lot of videos will be done in here because we're always wrenching in here, doing things, detailing. Stay tuned, you'll see a lot more things from all of us and me and Hugh and our friends as well that are all joining on this Porsche bandwagon. Until next time, just keep an eye out for our next video and let us know in the comments what you want to see and hear from us. We're an open book. We can talk about allocations, how you get them, our journey of how we've collected our cars, things like that. Until next time, thanks guys.